Any UGA news today? No? We'll just talk about these bowl games then. YouTube today. Thanks for watching. I really appreciate it. Also, and to in addition to that as well, subscribe to the channel if you're not already. Click the thumbs up button. I post college football videos almost every single day of the year. Blah, 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 blah. Justin Fields. Why'd he transfer? What do I think about it? Where's he going? How mad am I? Am I surprised? No! Did you watch the live show yesterday? I told you this yesterday at 3 o'clock. Read through the comments, though. I'm an idiot. I don't know what I'm talking about. Justin Fields ain't going nowhere. Okay, well, he's gone. And for anybody that's about to say, well, I seen a quote from his mom or dad that said nothing's official and he's just exploring his options and nothing. Listen. Are you married? Huh? Go home today, sit your wife down and tell her you're exploring the possibility of a divorce. Tell her your mind's not made up, but you're considering it. Let me know how it works out. Justin Fields is gone, people. He's transferring. Where is he going? My money's on Ohio State. That's where I think he's headed. Some other contenders. I think there's really only three choices. Ohio State, Oklahoma, Florida State. To me, those are the three options. Now, obviously, he's free to go wherever he wants. Believe me if you want. But that's where I think he'll end up, one of those three places. Am I mad? No. I don't blame Justin Fields for transferring at all. Lot of rumors, innuendo, whatever about why he's transferring, all these kinds of things. I don't know why he's transferring. I have some ideas. And again, if you've been watching me over the course of the season, you probably know what those ideas are. But I do not think Justin Fields is transferring because he didn't start at quarterback this year. I don't believe that for a second. He came to a team that had an entrenched starting quarterback who had went to a national title game. So I don't believe he's transferring because he's not starting. I don't think he's transferring because some drunk baseball player in the stands at a football game called him the N-word. He didn't even hear that. Now, I know I'm sure he saw it on the news or heard about it on camera or whatever, so I'm not saying he doesn't know about it, but I don't think he's transferring because some idiot called him the N-word. I don't believe that either. Now, some people are saying he was promised certain things from Kirby Smart when he was being recruited, and Kirby Smart didn't deliver on those things. Now that, I honestly don't know. God only knows what these coaches tell these recruits to try to get them to commit, not just Justin Fields. I'm sure these recruits are told and promised all sorts of things, but I have no idea what Justin Fields was told or promised when he was recruited. My opinion, some people agree with us, some don't. Again, I don't really care. This is just my opinion. I think he's transferring because he wasn't treated like a quarterback. Not because he didn't start. Not because he didn't get what he thought was enough playing time. Not because he thinks he's better than Jake Fromm. Not because he doesn't want to compete for a starting position, which is popular amongst people who have hated Justin Fields since the moment we signed him. Oh, he's just a baby. He doesn't want to compete. He's a spoiled brat who wants to get his way. I don't believe any of that. I don't believe Georgia and our coaching staff treated Justin Fields like a quarterback. I said this all year, right? You send this guy in, you got him handing the ball off 20, 25 times a game in the second halves of these blowouts. You send him in on random second down plays for absolutely no reason to run quarterback draws and quarterback sweeps. If you watch Georgia play this year, honestly, the majority of the time we sent Justin Fields into the game, it was like we were using him as an extra running back. A fourth, fifth, or sixth string running back. And Justin Fields does not want to do that. Justin Fields wants to play quarterback. And people say, well, what do you think? He's just going to take Fromm's job? No, I didn't say that all year. Not one time did I suggest that Justin Fields should be starting ahead of Jake Fromm. Jake Fromm is one of the best five college quarterbacks in America, in my opinion. He's an elite college-level quarterback. But the point is, you bring Justin Fields in, he gives you something totally different than what you get from Fromm. But who are you fooling, right? When all you're doing with Justin Fields is running him every single day. It just made no sense the way they were using him. And I don't think he liked the way he was being used. And I don't blame him. He wants to be an NFL quarterback. You can't do that running around. Now, I'm under the impression that Georgia's coaches just do not know how to use a Justin Fields. That's not a knock on Kirby or Chaney or Pittman or any of the other guys over on the offensive staff. I'm not knocking them. They are elite pro-style offensive coaches. Look what they've done with Jake Fromm in the Georgia offense. We're 13th in America this year in points per game. Jake Fromm looks like an All-American candidate in the last 4 or 5 weeks of the season. I'm not complaining about the coaches, but the reality is Jim Chaney has been coaching pocket passers since the 80s, okay? I don't think Georgia knows how to utilize a true dual threat quarterback. I don't think they do. I think that became obvious to Justin Fields. I do think Justin Fields got frustrated. So some of these people are saying he's acting out or whatever. Some of that may be true. I do think he was frustrated because we did not use him as a quarterback. And you say, well, I had people say this yesterday, you can't send your it's rude to send your backup quarterback into the game in the second half and have him throwing the ball. Looks like you're just trying to run up the score. No, it looks like you're preparing your team, right, in case something happens to your starting quarterback. We spent this entire season, one Jake Fromm twisted ankle away from having Justin Fields as our starting quarterback. And I feel like our coaches, and this is a theme, and I harped on this all year, I feel like Georgia's coaches did absolutely nothing during the season to prepare Justin Fields to be a college-level quarterback. And that's what he wants to be, not a running back. Justin Fields is not Nick Marshall, okay? He can throw the ball. Did he look impressive when they did put him in and let him throw the ball once or twice? It was up and down. I mean, he completed 70% of his passes, right? What did he have? 5 touchdown passes, 0 interceptions. And I know a lot of this came against inferior opponents. I get that. But the point is, look at Alabama, and I talked about this all year, and wow, did I get proven right in the SEC championship game. All year long, right? Alabama's beating these teams 40-50 points at halftime. What do? They take Tua out. They put Hurts in the second half. What is Hurts doing? Is Hurts handing the ball off 45 times in the second half and running QB sneaks? No. Jalen Hurts came in the game in the second half for Alabama this year and ran the Alabama offense. Why? In case your starting quarterback goes down, the other guy needs to be ready. You don't want him rusty. Now, Alabama was doing this with a quarterback who started for 2 full seasons in Hurts. They kept him prepared all year long by letting him run the real offense in the second half of games, regardless of what the score is. It's not Alabama's concern whether or not the other team can't stop them in the second half and Alabama ends up winning by 50 instead of 40. And it shouldn't be Kirby Smart and Georgia's concern that South Carolina or Tennessee or Vandy or Mizzou or any of these other teams that we had big leads on in the second half. It shouldn't be Kirby Smart or Georgia's fault or responsibility to try to keep from hurting their damn feelings at the expense of getting a Georgia player ready to play. And what happened in the SEC title game? Tua goes down, Hurts comes in and looks like a friggin' All-American. Why? He had been preparing all year! That's why. We treated Justin Fields like a running back, and now he's gone. Period. Am I mad about it? No. We're not hurting at the quarterback position, unless Fromm goes down. But let's be real. Almost every team in America would be hurting if their starting quarterback went down. It's a luxury to be an Alabama and have a Hurts and a Tua, to be a Georgia and have a Fromm and a Fields. That's a luxury that not too many teams have, and not too many teams have that very often. Alabama hasn't been in a situation quarterback-wise like they're in right now every single year under Saban. This is unique. Georgia has been in a lucky situation with their QBs over the last few years with the number of high 4 and 5-star QBs that we've had going back to Jacob Eason. Those things don't last forever. So, you know, Fromm goes down, we're next to nothing at this point at the quarterback position. You're putting all your eggs in the Plumtree basket or whatever this guy's name is from Mississippi. What's his name? John Reese Plumtree, Plumlee. This guy's a smaller, slower, less talented, shorter version of Justin Fields. And our coaches couldn't do anything with Justin Fields, who was the number one rated dual threat quarterback in America last year. All of a sudden, Georgia fans think they're going to be able to do something with the 265th rated player in America in Justin Plumtree. Now, I like Justin Plumtree as a backup quarterback, so I'm not putting him down. But the reality is losing Justin Fields, I mean, that's not good. He's going to go somewhere, right? Now, it looks like it's not going to be the SEC, like I said. I think Ohio State, Oklahoma, or Florida State. I pray to God we don't end up playing Justin Fields in the playoffs. Not because I think we would lose or can't beat him or anything like that, but this is setting up to be a dangerous situation for the University of Georgia, in my opinion. You could be looking at a situation where Jacob Eason is already at Washington. I think he's going to light it up next year in that Chris Peterson offense playing against West Coast teams. It won't surprise me at all to see Jacob Eason throw for 4,000-plus yards next year and 35-40 touchdowns. I mean, it will not surprise me one bit. And if you pay any attention at all to college football, you won't be surprised either when that happens. God forbid Washington goes undefeated or wins the Pac-12 and makes the playoffs with Jacob Eason next year. You could be looking at a situation where Georgia is watching Jacob Eason in the playoffs with another team, and then a year or two down the road, depending on where Fields lands, you could be watching Justin Fields in the playoffs with another team. If either one of those two things if Jacob Eason or Justin Fields wins a national title with a team not named the Georgia Bulldogs, and we don't, that's going to be a very hard pill to swallow, and that's the type of thing that is going to be really hard to get over, not as from a fan perspective, but from a program perspective. That could be a really bad situation. And it's a good possibility in my mind that either Jacob Eason or Justin Fields makes the playoffs sometime in the next couple of years. Now, Georgia's got a great chance to make the playoffs too. So again, and this isn't, I hope no one's taking this the wrong way. There was no way Justin Fields was starting this year. Fromm is clearly the better quarterback at UGA than Justin Fields. Clearly. I mean, it is not close. Like I said, Jake Fromm is an elite college-level quarterback, and towards the end of this season, there was not five quarterbacks in America that were playing better than Jake Fromm. There just wasn't, period. So, and that gets back to why I don't blame Justin Fields for leaving. He doesn't want to sit around, and like I said, when we did play him this year, it looked like we had no clue what we were doing with him, and I honestly feel that we don't. I don't think we truly know. I don't think we have the coaches, and I'm not knocking the There's going to be people in the comment section who take everything I say here the wrong way. I already know that. I'm not knocking Kirby, Chaney, Pittman, any of the offensive staff. But they're pro-style guys. They're pro-style guys. I don't think they have a clue what to do with Justin Fields or somebody like him. And if you watch the games this year, it's hard to come to any other conclusion, in my mind. So anyway, that's sort of how I feel about it. I think this is good news for Georgia. This is definitely good news for Georgia for the 2019 season, in my opinion. Fields was becoming a distraction, not because of anything he had done, but it's just every time Fromm threw an incomplete pass or had a bad game, he had half the fan base clamoring for Fields. I didn't want to have to go through a second year of that. So I think for this year, this works out good for Georgia. Now, we'll see what Fromm does after 2019 in terms of opting to go pro or coming back for a senior year. Given the fact that we just lost Justin Fields, I really hope Fromm sticks around for 4 years, because I do not believe we're going to get another quarterback anywhere near the level of Fromm, Fields, or Eason for the next couple of years. We were extremely lucky, like I said, over a 3 or 4 year period to get three elite quarterbacks in three classes in a row. The odds of that happening again are very, very slim in my mind. You got some fans, Georgia fans, but fans of every team do this. Any player we end up signing, you're going to have some percentage of the Georgia fan base who are going to jump on that train. Oh, well, yep, he's better than this guy anyway, or he's better than that guy anyway. I mean, you know, that's just how fans are. So there's nothing you can do about that. But I'm talking in terms of ratings, rankings, true talent. I don't see Georgia going through a QB cycle like we had over the last 3 years again anytime soon. This will not hurt us, in my opinion, for next year. We'll see what happens with the recruiting. Justin Fields, there were a lot of players, particularly in the state of Georgia, highly ranked and rated players, particularly in the state of Georgia, who wanted to play with Justin Fields. We'll see if that has any effect at all. Hasselwood, forget about him. He decommitted a couple of months ago, but he's been sort of keeping UGA as an option. I think that's gone now. Him and Justin Fields are really good friends. Zero chance we get Hasselwood now. I think we'll still get Blaylock, though. I'm okay with that. We'll see if this has any effect on these kids we're looking to get from IMG. Noah Kane was a possibility. Higher up on our wish list was Sanders, Trey Sanders, a couple of running backs there. So we'll see. N'Kobe Dean. Nolan Smith is a lock in my mind, number one player in America. He's coming to Georgia. But we'll see if this Justin Fields thing has any residual effect on recruiting. But in terms of on-the-field product for 2019, I actually think this probably benefits Georgia, like I said, in the short term. Long-term effect, we'll have to wait and see if there is one and if it's negative or positive. That will depend on what happens with Justin Fields, how he performs wherever he goes, and, of course, what happens with Georgia going forward at the quarterback position. Anyway, that's trying to give you the thoughts on that the best I can. I'm going to make this real quick at the end here with some bowl games today. Actually, there's only one bowl game today, but I'm going to do today's game, tomorrow's game, and Thursday's game. Then I'll make another video for the Friday and Saturday game. So tonight you got Northern Illinois and UAB. Now, if you've been following along with these bowl picks, and we got the Bowl Mania Pick'em Challenge thing going with ESPN and everybody in the comments section, I started 6-0. I picked all favorites. Not the case here. Now, first one I am going to pick the favorite. UAB is favored by 2.5 over Northern Illinois in the Boca Raton Bowl. Northern Illinois 8-5, UAB 10-3. Why am I picking UAB? I like the story of UAB. It was wrong what happened to them. I've done some videos on that. Alabama basically shut that program down over a 40-year-old grudge dating back to Bear Bryant and Bear Bryant Jr. Petty, pitiful, pathetic. Little man syndrome going on with Alabama, the way they treated UAB. Program went away for a while, just came back within the last year or two, and here they are sitting at 10-3 in a bowl game, a 2.5-point favorite. Feel-good story to me. Give me the Blazers, UAB, late at 2.5. Now, tomorrow you got San Diego State versus Ohio. Not Ohio State, just regular Ohio. Ohio's a 2.5-point favorite in this one. This is the Frisco Bowl, played in Frisco, Texas. Listen, if the best you can do for the name of the bowl game is to just name it after the city it's played in, you might not need to have that bowl game. That goes for the Las Vegas Bowl, the New Orleans Bowl. Here we are with the Frisco Bowl. I don't understand. If you can't get a sponsor or you can't come up with a creative name, you're just naming it after the city. To me, that tells me we shouldn't have this bowl game at all. There's way too many bowl games. San Diego State 7-5 versus Ohio at 8-4. Ohio's a 2.5-point favorite. I'm going to take the underdog in this one. I like San Diego State. Didn't they beat Stanford earlier in the year or played them close? Anyway, they're the underdog, but the favorites can't keep winning forever. Give me the Aztecs, I think. Yeah, San Diego State, and give me the 2.5. All right, and this one's Thursday night, and I think this could be a good game here. You got Marshall playing South Florida in the Gasparilla Bowl. Huh? What is Gasparilla? I had to Google it. It's a pirate festival.
I'm Captain Jack Sparrow.
Okay, I take back what I said earlier about naming bowl games after the city they're in. I would much rather this be the Tampa Bowl. The Gasparilla Bowl. What is that? A pirate festival, really? I don't know, man. Marshall 8-4 is a 3-point favorite against South Florida. This is a home game for South Florida. They're in Tampa. They're 7-5, Marshall 8-4. I'm going to take the underdog again. Give me South Florida. I'll take the 3 points, though, but I think South Florida gets it done in like what I said is basically a home game. But the Gasparilla Bowl, get real. All right, that's it. I appreciate you guys watching. We have a live show tonight at 10 p.m. Eastern where I take phone calls. I'm sure a lot of you will have a lot to say about this Justin Fields situation, so please tune in tonight, 10 o'clock Eastern time, Uncle Lou Live right here on LouTube. I'll be taking all you guys' phone calls, and we'll see what you guys think about this Justin Fields situation. Maybe some of these bowl games, whatever else you want to talk about. Appreciate you guys watching, and have a great morning.